Are you having trouble explaining to users why they should use your app? Well, if so, that's what we're going to fix today. So a lot of people come to us with questions about how to carry out the research phases or how to make sure they're validating their app. And maybe they've started talking to their target market about their app idea, but they're being met with some confusion and they're having trouble explaining why people should use their app in the first place. Now, on their end, they know they have this really great app idea, but again, it's just not being met. It's not being responded to in the way they thought it would. Now, oftentimes there's one specific culprit at play here, one main thing you need to focus on and change in order to fix this. Now, there can be a lot of other factors at play, but we're going to talk about one of the main ones specifically today so you can move forward quickly and make a change and make sure people know not just why they need your app, but why they should want your app. So if you're new around here, my name is Kristen, and I'm the co-founder of Coaching No Code Apps. We help business owners and industry experts build custom apps to start their app-based businesses or grow their existing businesses, all without coding. All right, so how do you fix this? Well, what I'm gonna do is share my screen, and we're gonna jump over to the whiteboard. Let me just make sure we are all shared here. Okay, there we go. And we're going to talk through this. So let me draw out this model here. When you are looking at your target market, the group of people who you want to bring on board to your app, who you want to sell your app to, we find that entrepreneurs usually end up targeting people in one of three different levels or categories. Now, down at the bottom here, we have target markets or prospective users who are not only aware of the problem your app is solving, because remember that your app is being created to solve a specific problem. So they're not only aware of this problem, but they are in pain from it every single day, or every time they go through the process of whatever your app is solving. Maybe it's something they do at work, maybe it's something they do in their lives. They're constantly aware that they have this problem, they need a solution, and they're in pain from it. And what I mean by that is they're being affected in negative ways. Maybe they are wasting a bunch of time simply because they don't have a better way to do something. Maybe they're losing money. Or maybe they're not able to grow their businesses in the right way, for example. But they're constantly being held back by this problem. Now, moving up, we have a group of users who are aware of the problem that your app is solving, but they're not in pain from it. So these could be people who are maybe associated with or related to the lower group in some way. Maybe they are colleagues, maybe they're friends or family, for example. They know about the problem, they know the problem exists. So if it's an industry problem within, you know, maybe a niche segment of businesses, they still know about the problem, but they're not experiencing the pain from it on a day-to-day basis like the people in the bottom group are. And then up at the top here, we have people who are not aware. These are people who don't understand that a problem exists. Even if your app is being built specifically for these people, they don't even know that the problem exists in the first place. So they don't understand the solution. If you don't know what the problem is, you're never going to understand a solution, right? So we have three different types of people here. Now, it's really, really common to see app entrepreneurs targeting the wrong level of person. Now, to be clear, it's not right or wrong necessarily to target any one of these levels, but there is a way to do it that's going to make it a heck of a lot easier for you. So at the bottom here, in this lower level, we have people with a very high need for your app, because again, they're aware of the problem and they're experiencing it day in and out, right? They're in pain from that problem. And then up at the top here, we have people who are in low need of your app. Now, this isn't to say that they wouldn't buy your app or use your app, but they probably don't need it because they don't even know that they're experiencing a problem in the first place. Now, again, you have to think about, because it might seem like, well, why would you ever build something for these people? But you have to think about products that, you didn't really know existed before. Think about Instagram. Did you have this need for an app that lets you scroll through pictures with little subtitles? No, you probably never thought to yourself, gosh, I have this problem where I need to share my, you know, my photos in this way or whatever it may be, right? You had a low need for it. You weren't aware of the problem, probably. Even if you experienced frustration in not being able to share your photos in the way you wanted, you probably weren't able to pinpoint the specific problem that you were experiencing, right? So you were in low need of the app, but that doesn't mean you don't use the app every day, okay? So to be clear, you can have your users in any one of these levels, but it's always, always, always going to be easier for you to explain your app and convert potential users into real users when they are lower on this scale or in this model. When they are towards the bottom, it's always going to be easier for you to explain your app to them or for them to just understand why they need your app in the first place. So, on the flip side, when you have people who aren't really aware of the problem that you're solving, they have a low need for your app. And so usually, if you're targeting this segment of people or this target market, you're going to have to convince them or teach them why they need your app. It's not going to be as simple as saying, hey, I have this app that does X, X, and X, and having them immediately want to use it. You're going to have to say, hey, I have this app that does X, X, and X, and the reason why you need it is because blah, 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 right? This is what you're currently doing. This is the way it could change what you're doing. These are all the great things that will come from making those changes, and so on. Right? You're going to have to convince them. You're going to have to teach them. There's probably going to be a longer trial period where they're making sure that they really want to use the app because they don't really have a problem they're solving, right? This is just an add-on, sort of. So when you have people in this top section, you're really having to go a lot more in depth into why they need your app. And if you don't know how to properly talk about or market or sell your app in the first place, you're gonna have a lot of trouble here. But just like on the other side, at the bottom here, for people who are not only aware of the problem you're solving, but they're in pain from it constantly, you are going to be welcoming them into your app. You don't have to say, hey, I have this app that does this, this, and this, and I created it because you have this problem that you might not have been aware of, but this problem is insert problem here, and it's doing all these things, or it's causing you to go through all these things. But think of what it would look like on the other side. For example, you don't have to go through any of that. All you have to do is say, hey, you know that problem that you have with X? Well, I have an app that solves that. Pretty easy. Honestly, they don't even need to know what the app does. They just need to understand the problem and know that there's a solution. And if there's a solution, it's usually going to be an easier conversion process, an easier process of bringing them from being prospective users or leads and converting them into being customers or paying users. So if you're having trouble explaining to your target market why they need your app, you might be targeting the wrong people. You might be looking too high up on this scale, in this model. You might be looking at people who aren't aware of the problem, and therefore they have a low need for your app, and you're having to convince or teach them why they even need it in the first place, because they don't know the problem is there. If you change who you're targeting, and these can still be in the same market, but maybe a different segment of the market. You want to be targeting people who have a high need for your solution. They know what the problem is. Mention the problem to them and they go, "Ugh, I know, right? I need to solve that." That's the type of person who, if you can target them, you're going to have a much easier time not only explaining your app, you're not going to be met with that confusion, but you're going to have an easier time converting them. You're not going to have to convince and teach. You're going to be welcoming them into your app if you've built the product correctly. So again, you don't have to stay away from people who are unaware of the problem, for example. This isn't to say that you can't sell your app to them. It is to say that you're going to have a much easier time if you work your way down to people who are in high need, who know the problem is there, who are in pain from the problem, and who you can simply welcome onto your app once you have that solution up and running. So this could be the culprit for you, and I hope that was helpful. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.